Hi everyone, welcome to my very chatty video about the topic, Where Has Beth Been? Where have I been? And basically, it is kind of a long story and it is super chatty. And unless you're one of my subscribers, you may not even be interested in this. I'm going to tell you a little bit about what my 2.5 years experience on YouTube has been about, my feelings about it, what it has been for me. I guess I can't speak for any other YouTuber, but it has been kind of surprising the things that I have learned here on YouTube about the difficulties of being on YouTube. I really wish that I were already retired because then I could keep up the 2 videos per week. That was always my plan. I thought it would be a great, creative, fun thing to do in retirement, but I am still 2 years away from retirement. And well, let me just go ahead and tell you where I am right now and tell you a little bit about the YouTube experience, at least for me. And I guess I'll start with the YouTube experience first. You know, my background early on was in drama. I was a theater major. I ended up getting an HR degree because I didn't complete my degree originally. And then there was a 1-year degree completion program in HR, which I would be a terrible HR person because I am not very detail oriented at all. But that was what Friends University here in town offered in terms of a degree completion program. And I had 3 years of a theater degree way back when, years and years, decades ago, when I was at WSU as a theater major. I ended up quitting school because I got involved in a local dinner theater, and then I did a children's TV show, and life kind of happened. I married the audio person on that children's show. It was called One of a Kind. And you know, the ideas on that children's show, One of a Kind, have stayed with me my whole life. And I think it's something that behind the scenes I kind of bring to my YouTube channel. The whole idea behind that show is to teach children you are one of a kind and special, that we all have gifts, we all have talents, we are all beautiful, no matter our skin color, our size, our height, our beliefs, we are all beautiful. We are just each a sparkle in God's radiant world. That was a little weird way to say that. I don't know if that came out very well. But basically, each of us is just a little bright shining light out here. And if each of us do the best with what we have in all kinds of ways, use the talents and blessings that God gave us, then what a wonderful world this can be. And also, although none of us are perfect, including me, you know, I get angry and I lash out sometimes, but mostly I think we should try to treat each other with love and respect. Okay, well that goes back to 2.5 years ago before I started my YouTube channel. And for about 6 months before I started my YouTube channel, I discovered YouTube. I never knew about it. I guess I was 58 when I started watching YouTube and I really realized there was great skincare here. I watched Angie of Hot and Flashy. I got on Retin-A, which is one of the best things that I've ever done for my skin. I learned makeup techniques. Sometimes I'm a little bit overdone with my makeup and I'm trying to kind of inch back on that a little bit. I thought, wouldn't it be fun to kind of go back to my theater roots and start a YouTube channel? And so I did that. So up to the reason that I kind of disappeared from YouTube 3 weeks ago. And basically that is that over the last maybe year, I have been realizing that doing 2 videos a week and working full-time, my sister and I own a company together, and it's very demanding. My husband, well, and I guess me too, we have a bunch of rental houses, and I used to really be active in those, and I'd pull my sleeves up and get out the paintbrush or whatever and work with him on the weekends in those houses. Well, he did retire, so I felt kind of justified in kind of passing him the rental house business and letting him do that, and I did my company and then the 2 videos per week. In many cases, I got Friday afternoons off, although for a while we were so busy at work, I couldn't take Friday afternoons off, which meant that it took me all day Saturday and all day Sunday and some mornings to do the 2 videos. You know, it doesn't take that long to shoot a video, but then the editing process takes a long time and I didn't have anyone to edit. I did my own editing. I still do. And the reality for me was even when I did get Friday afternoons off, it was pretty much Friday afternoons and all day Saturday and all day Sunday with me doing the videos. And when you do videos, it is a very solitary kind of a thing. I'm sitting here right now in my room all by myself, and then I would be editing for hours all by myself. And quite honestly, after a long day of figuring out what videos to do, filming the videos, and then editing the videos, I was so exhausted at the end of the night that basically I either wanted to stay home and go to bed, or maybe go out to a movie with my husband. and a lot of my social life kind of went by the wayside some. And Alan, my husband, although he's very, very supportive of me and wants me to do what makes me happy, which I really appreciate, I could tell that he really didn't love YouTube. He would make the comment, all you do is think about YouTube anymore, and you're always looking at your cell phone to check your subscribers, to check your comments. Even when you're here with me, you're not here with me. And so for the past year or so, I have realized that making two videos, working full-time, and trying to help my husband somewhat on the rental houses was too much for me. And also, one of the central ideas behind my channel is to make our second half our best half. And I really did a lot of thinking about that, and I thought, you know, right now, I'm feeling burnt out, I'm feeling overworked, I don't have enough fun time to do the things I want to do, and I got kind of an obsession with buying makeup, and I have the money, it's not that, but it's like, you know, who needs 75 eyeshadow palettes? You know, I don't know that's what I have, but I would not be a darn bit surprised if I didn't have that many. I could not use all the makeup that I have if I live three more lives. And I also thought about my purpose here. I've really always wanted to help people. That makes me feel really good. And I realized that kind of all I was doing was selling makeup. And in our second half, a lot of us are on fixed incomes. And the last thing we need is, you know, the sixth or seventh or eighth mascara. And so really, I was having all of these thoughts and I was just doing the work and doing the two videos and enjoying it a lot of the time, but being frustrated some of the time because I would feel like I had to make two videos a week and sometimes I didn't think they were the quality maybe that they should be. And so I did decide at that point to go back to one video a week until I get to retirement, which will be 2 years. And then I would have the time to make the two videos a week if I still feel good about doing that or enjoy doing that. So that was kind of my plan 3 weeks ago, was to cut my videos down to one a week. Well, then life intervened. And about 3 weeks ago on a Friday evening at about 11 o'clock, we got a call from Alan's mother that Alan's dad was having severe breathing difficulties. And she had called the ambulance. And so we got out of our PJs, threw jeans on, no makeup, whatever, ran out the door, went over to Donna Darlene's house, and the ambulances were there. There were two ambulances, and they took Don away, and they took him to the emergency room, and we followed in our car, and then we spent the whole night in the emergency room with Don, and he had terrible breathing issues, like his abdomen seemed to be just kind of spasming. It was very unusual and very odd, and the doctor basically said that unless they could get him to breathe normally, he wouldn't make it. So they put him on what I later learned was life support. I never really knew what life support was, but one of the first things is this thing called a ventilator. They put it down the person's throat, and there's a big machine that breathes for them. And so Don was put on that ventilator, and amazingly, the next morning, they tested to see if he could breathe on his own, and thank the Lord he could, but he was still not out of the water. And so we spent that whole weekend at the hospital with Don in ICU. And it was really kind of wonderful because the whole family gathered around at the hospital all weekend long and through the next week. And my son Dylan and his girlfriend were there at the hospital with us. And my other son who lives in Grand Rapids, he and his wife came. It was a very serious period for Don and for our family. But fortunately, Don did very well. He was in the hospital for a week, and then he went to the rehab hospital for another week, and now he's home with Darlene, and he's doing very well. And so really, for most of the last 3 weeks, I've been dealing with the family issue there and trying to keep things going at work and that kind of a thing. So anyway, that is where I have been for the last 3 weeks. And thank you to those of you who sent in comments and said, we miss you, what's going on, I hope you're okay. I really do appreciate that. And I am not sure when I'm going to make my next video. I have a really good idea for a video, something in terms of skincare that I am so excited to share with you. And it is less than $5. And it has made a big difference in my skin. If I can draw any conclusion from the last year or so, especially the last month, is in our second half, it is really important for all of us to figure out exactly how we want that second and final half to look, and to really do things that benefit those around us and also bring us joy in our lives. And so that is what I've been doing, is kind of evaluating that. And quite honestly, you know, there's a part of me that is enjoying not doing YouTube because I am living my life. For instance, this afternoon, it's a Saturday morning about 10:30, and at 1:30, me and about three girlfriends are going to the holiday tables, I think it's called. I have not seen them in years, but it is an event at the local art museum where people decorate tables for the holidays, and that will be a lot of fun. And when I was really in the thick of doing two videos a week, I probably would not have taken the time to do that. So I guess my thought for the day is, to all of us in our second half, time is short. As much as I like to say things like youthing and not really talk about age, it is happening to all of us. It is not too much fun, I have to admit, watching those changes. I'm basically not seeing any physically that are positive about aging. I suppose there are some emotional things that are positive about aging, that we feel a little better in our own skin and that sort of a thing. But if there's anything I can take away from this, is that every now and then it's important to step back from our lives and really evaluate and ask if we are where we're supposed to be and if we're happy being there. So anyway, thank you for listening to my current thoughts, and I look forward to seeing you in my next video.